The WEG programming software allows you to manage multiple drives. A group of drives is called a configuration, and each drive is a resource. So the workflow is simple. Create a configuration, then add as many resources to that configuration as you need. And by the way, WPS isn't limited to just a CFW-300 drive. It's used for lots of other WEG devices, like PLCs, safety controllers, servos, etc., which means everything we talk about in this video will apply to those too. And then once you set up your configuration, you can then configure the resources and monitor the resources and view trends, etc. for any device in the configuration. Let's do a simple example using just a single WEG CFW-300 VFD. Bring up the WPS software, create a new configuration, enter a name for the configuration, and a path to store it at. Now there has to be at least one resource, so you name the first one here. I'm using a 485 COM module and this USB to 485 adapter to communicate with this PC. If we plug the USB adapter into the PC and open the device manager, we see that the PC registers that as a serial port at this port number. So we select serial port and we put that COM port number here. The rest of these are the default values for the drive, and I haven't changed those, so I'll hit test and we see we're online and ready to go. Perfect. If you're not currently connected to a drive, then you can select your device here. We are online, and because we hit that test button in a previous dialog, WPS already knew we were talking to a CFW-300 drive and that we have an I/O module plugged into the drive. If you're not sure what device is out there, you can hit this Identify bus and it will automatically identify it for you. This dialog allows you to convert ladder code created in WLP into WPS. We don't need to do that, so just hit Finish. And we're back to our welcome screen, with one difference. Now we have a configuration to work with. There's our resource, and there's all the stuff associated with that resource. Double-click on this, and we can view and change our parameters just like we did in a previous video. We can start programming ladder code for the soft PLC. That's a pretty big topic, so we'll do that in a separate video. And finally, we can do all kinds of diagnostics and wizards. Let's take a closer look at those powerful tools. With this monitoring variable diagnostic, we can create a custom table of variables we want to monitor. They can be parameters, system variables, or soft PLC variables, any variable in the entire resource. Right-click, give it a name, and look, our new variable monitoring table appears down here. You can then add global or local variables. If local, then you can actually select which ladder file to pull them from. And you can search, which is a super easy way to find variables. We'll use this a lot in the soft PLC videos. For now, just be aware that you have this powerful tool available to you. With Trend, you can view up to 10 variables graphically in real time. We'll show you how to use that in a separate video dedicated to just the trend view. For both of these, you can create as many different monitoring and trend views as you want, and then just select the one you want when you need it. These wizards are fantastic. They show you all the common things you'll typically want to monitor in a nice clean format that's easy to visualize. For example, it is so much easier to double-click on this main signals wizard. Of course, I need to be connected to the drive for this to work, and instantly see everything I need to know about the drive in one place without having to remember that I need to look at parameter 295 to see the drive's rated current or parameter 27 to see what kind of I/O card is installed, etc. For example, if I watch a drive speed and status, and reach over and hit the Run button, sure enough, I see what the drive is currently doing. So this wizard shows me at a glance everything I need to know about the speed, current, voltage, temperature, VFD status, alarms, faults, and even the I/O status, which is all read-only information. Wizards with a blank icon like this are read-only wizards. Wizards with this icon have values you can change and have two buttons to help you manage that. The monitor button is already selected, so WPS is pulling the drive repeatedly right now and displaying the results on the screen. If I change parameter 402 on a drive, WPS shows the result on the screen. To write a value, you need to deselect the monitor button. Why? Because in monitor mode, WPS is reading the values over and over, right? Well, if a read occurs while you're trying to do a write, the value you're trying to write could get overwritten with the read value, and then that read value is what gets written to the drive, which isn't what you wanted. So be sure to exit the monitor mode before trying to write any values. Also notice that the background got a lot lighter when I deselected the monitor button. That's to remind you that you're not in monitor mode. So to write values, just change any of the offline parameters you want and hit the right button. And we see the result appear at the drive. Now, one side note, you can't write to the drive while you're editing a parameter on the drive. You must be outside of editing the parameter, change it in the wizard, write it out, then drop back into it on the drive to see the change. That ensures that important parameters can't be modified in two places at the same time, and it applies to any parameter that has this CFG indication in the parameter summary chart. This tab tells me my motor settings. This one is all about how the drive is controlled for both local and remote operations. Here I can see what the keypad speed is currently set to and that it's stored in parameter 121. This one shows me my ramps and min and max speed references and even a plot to show me how they all fit together. It also shows me the functionality of the I/O pins and the connector pinout. And there's even subtabs showing me the status of whichever module I have plugged in. This wizard is showing me how the LCD display is set up and how the data will be scaled. And again, I see all the parameter numbers associated with those values. The motor control wizards are cool because they show you graphically how all the parameters play together. And the overload wizard does the same thing. The bottom line is, these wizards make visualizing how your drive is configured so much easier than poking around with individual parameters and building your own variable monitoring window. Want to add another resource? Well, just right-click on the configuration and add one and go through all the same steps we just did in this example. To delete it, just right-click and delete. WPS can even manage multiple configurations. Just create the new configuration exactly the way we did in this video. Well, there's our new configuration and the resource we just created. And again, to delete a configuration, just right-click and delete. Well, that ought to be enough to get you going with configurations and give you a pretty good idea of all the tools that are available to you to help you monitor and debug the drive. Click here to learn more about the WEG CFW-300 Variable Frequency Drive. Click here to see all of AutomationDirect's free award-winning support options, and click here to subscribe to our YouTube channel so you'll be notified when we publish new videos.